course, Memorial Day.
Well, it's important on many levels, but one of them, first of all, we can learn a lot from it. And perhaps what people learn is that we shouldn't tolerate racism and discrimination, and we must fight against it. So that'd be one of the lessons, because this has actually demonstrated what can happen to people when a nation, civilization breaks down, and when they actually create, they design and build machines to kill people. It's something that's never happened before. I mean, there have been many genocides, but this one was different. The Holocaust was different because it was done on an industrial scale. And as I said before, machines for killing people in industry. It was an industry.
You gave a very inspirational and moving speech today. Why do you think it's important that you're able to come and tell people, especially young people, why do you do what you do?
Well, because I realise, I've been told this, that hearing a survivor, hearing somebody and meeting somebody who was actually there, brings the history, which is now quite remote to them, because it's over 70 years since liberation. So, seeing someone who was actually there, brings the history closer to them and makes it much more believable, because the events were so unbelievable.
This year's theme for Holocaust Memorial Day was the power of words. Mm. What does that mean to you?
Well, you know, actually I quite like words. I think that you have to use them carefully, and some words, I mean, it's an absolute art using words. And some can be so powerful that they, well, we saw that with Hitler. He was very powerful in the way he put it over. I haven't analysed his words, but they were obviously very effective. But they were used to the wrong purpose. He could have made peace with them, but he made war with them. So words are very important, and they can really be very powerful.
Heard from a lot of young people. Why is it important that they now go out and spread the same messages?
Yes, well, because they're our future. They are the future leaders, and they need to be informed and equipped to really deal with the modern world. And the problem is that now we have more than just words, we have technology. They're still words, they're written words, but they can sort of be disseminated so quickly, and they can reach millions of people all at once. And if these people have the power to act, it can do a lot of damage. It can also do a lot of good. It's quite complex.
If there was one message you would like to take people who are leaving this event to take away with them, what would that message be?
Well, apart from the positive fight to change the world for the better, to remember the victims, because when I speak, well, I'm here to tell the story, but I'm really also speaking for the people whose voices have been cut, whose voices have been silenced. And there's nobody to remember them. There's some people who didn't leave a single sign behind them because their families were taken, their extended families, their friends, their relatives, their whole villages have been eliminated. And there's nobody left to remember them. And if they're forgotten, then, as one young sixth former said to me in a letter, they will have got away with it.